Scion Labs. You are subject 452. You're here to test our new split technology. We'll be having you run a series of tests that will challenge both your cognitive and platforming abilities. However, before we get to any of that, we've got a small introduction course for you. It's really just a formality to make sure you know your basics. There are a number of actions you'll be performing throughout these tests. At any point, you can refer to the context actions list to see what actions you can perform and how you can perform them. Got that? Great. Moving on. You may find that during certain difficult tests you want to return to the menu. To do that, you can hit the menu button at any time. That about wraps it up. Good luck. One final thing before we finish up here. Legally speaking, we need your consent to continue running these tests. To cover us, we've gone ahead and made the menu button an impromptu permission slip. Our lawyers describe this as morally dubious at best, but technically legal. So as far as we're concerned, good enough. you're still getting your footing, but as per company policy, I'm required to read you a safety notice. There's a lot of stuff in here about what to do in the event of a fire or first aid training, but I'll just skip over that. What I really want to focus on is red buttons. Don't press them under any circumstances. Now, I know what you're thinking. If I shouldn't press any red buttons during the test, then why did you put them there? That's the thing. We didn't. To this day, we can't figure out where these red buttons are coming from. Every time we see one, we remove it, but they just keep popping back up. We're not really sure what they do yet, but they're red. That can't be good. I mean, if it were green, it'd probably immediately solve the test, but red? For all we know, it could be a self-destruct button. With that said, I'll just go ahead and mark you down as successfully completed safety orientation. I know you're still getting your footing, but as per company policy, I'm required to read you a safety notice. There's a lot of stuff in here about what to do in the event of a fire or first aid training, but I'll just skip over that. What I really want to focus on is red buttons. Don't press them under any circumstances. Now, I know what you're thinking. If I shouldn't press any red buttons during the test, then why did you put them there? That's the thing. We didn't. To this day, we can't figure out where these red buttons are coming from. Every time we see one, we remove it, but they just keep popping back up. We're not really sure what they do yet, but they're red. That can't be good. I mean, if it were green, it'd probably immediately solve the test, but red? For all we know, it could be a self-destruct button. With that said, I'll just go ahead and mark you down as successfully completed safety orientation. Wow, good jumps, 452. Not quite as impressive as subject 451, but I mean, hey, who's keeping track? Anyways, keep up the good work. You fell for that? Oldest trick in the book. That button does nothing.